We live in an infinite and expanding universe. Space has no edge. It goes on forever. But there could be a different kind of edge to our universe. An edge of time.
The universe seems to have begun 13.8 billion years ago in the past. So there's some inclination, some impression that it's finite in time.
What we call the Big Bang is, as far as we understand it, a beginning, a start of the universe. The universe has a finite age. Now, does it have an edge in the future?
We used to think that time would someday come to a catastrophic end, along with the planets, galaxies, and all life in the universe.
If we know there's a Big Bang, if we know the universe started, expanded, and cooled, it's very natural to wonder whether or not someday the expansion will stop, reverse, and come back. And that's a big crunch.
In a big crunch, our expanding universe will begin to contract. Stars and planets will smash into each other. Galaxies will collide. And all of the life left in space will be compressed with all other matter into a singularity. If this theory is true, then the universe will have a beginning and an end of time.
If we live in a universe that will expand, stop expanding, and then go back into a crunch, then it has an effect, two edges.
But there's a much stranger possibility.
Perhaps the end is but a beginning. Well, the universe is an oscillating universe. It has a Big Bang-like beginning. It expands to a maximum size, and then goes back into a big crunch and does that over and over.
We could be residents of a universe created from the ashes of another. A single universe in a stream of bouncing universes. Each full of galaxies, planets, and life. But our most recent observations of the universe suggests a big crunch isn't in the cards. Once again, dark energy is key. It's pushing our universe apart.
The universe is being dominated right now by dark energy, and because the dark energy doesn't seem to be fading away, it's easy to imagine eternal expansion toward the future.
For a while, we didn't know if the expansion of the universe was going to slow, stop, and reverse itself because of gravity. There are all these galaxies in the universe, and they're pulling on each other by their gravity. And if the expansion isn't fast enough, that gravity might be strong enough to stop the expansion and recollapse the universe. Now, with dark energy, we know that there's no way that can happen. The universe is going to expand forever because dark energy is pumping it full of acceleration.
The universe is not only expanding, but it's being driven by dark energy to expand faster and faster. And the dark energy doesn't dilute away, as far as we can tell. So the simplest idea is that the universe will simply continue to expand eternally toward the future.
Just like space, time would go on forever. It may sound like a better fate for life in the universe, but it's not.
One of the consequences of this dark energy that's causing the acceleration of the universe is that we eventually are headed towards the big chill. I should say, we're eventually headed towards the big chill. So the universe is getting colder and colder, and things are getting more and more spread out.
So the accelerated and continual and forever expansion of our universe might make for a frankly depressing end to time itself. This the ultimate entropy-based heat death of the universe, where you would walk out and see no stars in the sky. See absolutely nothing. There will come one day when the very last star in the universe just fizzles out, and that is it.
In the future, space will be a cold, dark, infinite void. where time goes on forever. There will be nothing to do but suffer in the internal expanse. It's our inevitable fate if there's no future edge of time in the universe. But even if there isn't an edge to the universe, could there be edges within the universe? April 2019, an international team of astronomers makes a special announcement.
And we are delighted to be able to report to you today that we have seen and taken a picture of a black hole. Here it is.
It's a picture of a supermassive black hole at the center of the M87 galaxy, 54 million light years away. It may also be the first image of an edge in the universe.
Black holes create a really interesting scenario when we think about space and the universe having edges.
This edge between space outside and inside a black hole is called the event horizon.
The event horizon of a black hole is a region within which, once you cross inside, the gravitational tug is so strong that even light cannot escape, which means nothing can escape once you cross inside the event horizon. So that really is sort of an edge, because it really does create a boundary.
The event horizon isn't a physical barrier in space.
The event horizon is an edge of the part of the universe we can visit. But it's not an edge in the sense that there's anything there. You would just pass right through it if you actually got right up to that place. So it's sort of a conceptual boundary between two different parts of the universe.
If we did send a manned probe to a black hole, it would be a one-way trip.
The event horizons of black holes are a sort of edge, because once you pass through an event horizon, you are cut off from the rest of the universe. You can never go back out. You are outside of our universe.
Once you've crossed inside that region, you are never coming back out. You know, and that's an edge.
Once inside the black hole, the probe would be in a separate part of space, cut off from the rest of the universe.
Falling through the event horizon of a black hole is like jumping over the edge of a cliff. You can see the edge, and you can see the edge go by, and then when you're at the bottom, you can look up and see what's happening at the top of the cliff, but you can never go back.
At the bottom of this black hole cliff sits a singularity, a region of space where the laws of physics go off the rails.
Deep toward that singularity could be as surprising as you might imagine, and yet still a possibility.
If you map the space-time around a black hole in a very particular way, there emerges a sort of mirror universe, a parallel universe on the other side of the black hole, identical to our own and traversable via the black hole.
So black holes are not just edges to our universe. They may also be gateways to other universes.
It's highly conjectured, but if there's ever going to be a space where, or a region, where you're making connections with, say, some other universe, a black hole in principle could be a portal to that.
But it's highly unlikely anyone will ever want to venture beyond an event horizon. And our pursuit of the other edges in the cosmos offers little hope. We can never travel beyond the cosmic event horizon. And we will never be able to see beyond the edge of our observable universe. So can we ever hope to discover the true edge of the greater universe? Or find out if it even has one?